special ed and a master in education degree from Ball State in early childhood. For more than 18 years, she has molded the lives of children with special needs and their families, provide special learning opportunities that address the needs of even the most diverse populations. So she's educated our children in Madison County for many years, and now she's started her own business called Ignite Learning, which is part of conscious discipline. And so the thing is, she couldn't be here today to speak, but her grandmother, Clara T. Lawson,
can you help me here with my chair?
Here to.
I think it's time.
Okay.
Is my dress down?
It's an honor to have you, Clara T. We're just so happy that you're here filling in for your granddaughter, Jenny. And I have all of the stuff here for you to use while you talk. There's a laptop here for you.
Why, a laptop? Well, my idea of a laptop is this right here. Why, my laptop's held many children over the years. I read them stories. We play games. Why, I even rock them to sleep. I comfort them when they're feeling sad right here on my laptop. What I need a laptop for here today?
Well, Clarity, a laptop these days is a computer. So the computer is here for your use.
And
And so we use it with a slideshow that Jenny has prepared for us. So
a slideshow?
Wait.
You want me to put on a slideshow?
Oh.
what you offer to others. Well, my mama always said, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Kind of like that, right? So you know what I did? I gave them candy. I gave them presents. Why, I even stayed up late doing their laundry. And do you think they did any of that for me? Do unto others. Well, let me sit here and finish putting on my lipstick. What you offer to others, you're strengthening yourself. Well, I guess maybe I do see a little sparkle in my eyes. Yeah, my eyes have always been one of my favorite features. So big and so round. Well, and those wrinkles. Well, my mama always said they were a sign of wisdom. I guess I should appreciate them. An awful lot of learning went along with those wrinkles, ladies. Yeah, learning that it's really not what I do to others that gets them to do things for me. Why, perhaps it's what I see in others that makes the difference. Well, maybe it's even what I see in myself that reflects what I see in others.
All right.
every week, whether I need to or not. When I walked in, all those ladies were sitting in a circle, drinking the coffee and chatting. Well, the closer I got, I realized they were talking about my friend, Barb. And what they were saying wasn't very nice. And I stopped for a minute and I thought, do I want to be a part of that? Well, the answer was no. So I went over into the group and I greeted the ladies like a proper woman would. And then I said, hey ladies, do you think that maybe the problem with Barb is that she's still not over grieving the death of her husband? And that maybe we could be more helpful by taking her a meal and sitting with her a while and talking about the happy memories instead of being hurtful and saying things here that might hurt her feelings. And guess what they said? Well, all right, I knew they were a good group of ladies anyways. They just needed a little help. So we did it. We went over there, we took dinner to her, and she was just delighted. It was awful nice. Be the change you want to see in the world. All right. So, do you have that selfie?
I do.
Can I see it?
Yeah.
Ooh, my, oh my. I never take a good picture. Ooh. And my stomach's getting a little upset. I get heartburn being up here in front of you after eating a meal. All you professional people make me nervous. It's a good thing I got my remedies. I always got something in my pocketbook that'll help me feel better. Yeah, I got my whole container of Tums. I go through a lot of Tums. And my peppermints for when my stomach gets sour. Every good granny knows she has to carry some chocolates. But when those grandchildren get sad, we just give them some chocolates and that always makes them feel better. And you gotta have your tissues, right? Uh-huh. Well, when all else fails and it gets real bad, I got Old Faithful. She's right here in my outside pocket. When I get real upset, I just pull her out and I sneak over behind the closed door and I take a big swing. Yeah, that always makes things better. Well, at least till tomorrow. Guess I haven't been a very good influence on Jenny. Ooh! Yeah, I think I've done that before. You know that time at night when you get to feeling kind of lonely? You get up and you go to the refrigerator even though you're not hungry. You gotta have something to eat. But guess what happens? Ooh! Yeah, end up looking like this. Well, must have been Jenny's parents that made the difference. I wasn't a very good influence on her, but they're such kind, caring, sweet Christian people.
Clara, I don't think Jenny expects you to be perfect.
Well,
she just wants to help people understand. There's something they can do when the world's not offering.
Well, chapter one. again. I can't believe I'm in the same place. But it isn't my fault. Well, it still takes me a long time to get out. Chapter 3. I walk down the same street. Oh my goodness, how long does it take this lady to learn a lesson? There is a deep hole in the sidewalk. Well, I see that it's there. I still fall in. Oh, it's a habit now. But my eyes are open. I know where I am. And it is my fault. I get out immediately. I walk down the same street. Chapter 4. There is a deep hole in the sidewalk. Well, I walk around it.
Oh, yeah. Woo!
Yeah! Chapter 5. We're almost there. I walk down a different street.
Hee 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 hee.